So boys, we are back, some more Redskins franchise mode here in Madden NFL 19, and today it's time to take a look at our 2019 preseason week 1, 2, and 3, and 4, the entire preseason basically as what we're going to be doing in this episode. So right now, before we do anything, we'll take a look at what we drafted in the NFL draft class. We did that one recap video yesterday where we went through the whole entire draft class and such like that, but this is going in depth a little bit more. So we got left guard Michael Jordan there, 77 overall, 22 years old. Richie Incognito is a 78, but I could see Michael Jordan taking over by the end of the season and holding on to that position for years upon years. Oh yeah, backup quarterback, that's right. So a quarterback, we have a situation. So we have Alex Smith, then we have newcomer Kelly Bryant, Kobe Bryant, I'm just going to call him Kobe. 72 overall, 22 years old. And then we got RG3, who was going to originally be our backup quarterback, but Kelly's better than him, though, so we might as well just let that happen and let Kelly be our backup quarterback. And taking a look at our quarterbacks, they're speedy as hell. Look at this. We have a 76 overall Alex Smith. Not that bad, actually. 87 Kobe Bryant, 85 RG3, and 87 Trevor Knight. If I call him Kobe Bryant, it's just a habit, a force of habit. But K Bryant, 72 overall, not that bad of a backup quarterback. Then we also drafted a left end? No, right end. Right end, Sharif Miller, 77 overall. He's our backup right end right now, and he's actually not that bad. I actually like what he brings to the table. So let's see if Sharif Miller does well at that backup role. And also at left tackle, that's right, I did draft the left tackle. Antoine Warmack, this dude is heavily underrated, actually. When I played with him in practice, he was holding his blocks like crazy. Like, he was doing well for a backup left tackle drafted in his position. So Antoine Warmack, I think he was our last drafted choice of the draft, and he's still pretty good, though. He's very good. So Antoine Warmack, liking what he brings to the table. But we also have some linebackers. So middle linebacker, drafted 7th overall, Devin White, 78 overall, 23 years old, starting at linebacker this year. He's going to do very well in his position with Zach Brown. Then at left outside linebacker, we have Terrell Lewis there, backing up Ryan Kerrigan. And if Kerrigan's overall goes down, I could see Terrell Lewis there taking over and holding on to that position for years to come, just like, who else is that? Michael Jordan, that's right. So we have Lewis and we have Michael Jordan possibly taking over for players next year. Then we have a cornerback starting this year, Trayvon Mullen up with Quentin Dunbar. Mullen's a 79 overall, 22 years old, very good player. He's got quick development, I believe, so he's going to be very good very soon. Then we have free safety, or not free safety right now, but a strong safety backup. We got Jonathan Abraham there, a 76 overall, 23 year old. Very good for his position right now at backup. We needed a backup strong safety. We got one now. So next up, we'll take a look at what's in there for undrafted free agents. I'll just sign a whole bunch because we have 53 roster spots being taken up and we got to take up like 73. So I got to do some digging here. I'll sign some players and just add them to the team. Okay, so went and added a whole bunch of dudes onto this team. So now we're at 70 out of 75 players, not that bad. We'll probably cut a majority of them or send them just a practice squad. But there's some pretty good players, though. Some decent gems upon that list I went and found. So tight end, did I get one? I did. Cole Strickland there, 72 overall, 24 years old, not that bad right there. At wide receiver, I found Nate Craig Myers. He's an 88 speed guy. Then I found a bunch of defensive tackles, a bunch of them, because we needed a bunch. So we could test those guys out, see who's the best. Linebackers, did I find some? I got Porsche, middle linebacker, I got nobody. Right outside linebacker, I got nobody. Cornerback, I think I found a couple cornerbacks like Duke Dawson and so on right there. Then at free safety, I found a backup guy, Clay Pratt, not that bad. Strong safety, I found Joseph Walruz. And I believe it's pretty much it, though. We found like a couple offensive linemen, some right ends and so on, like what is it? I think it was Sheem Green I got there at right end as a backup. And that left end, I got Zeeler right there, or Sealer. So, not that bad for some undrafted free agents. We also found our fullback as well, too, that I signed. I think it was last episode before we ended it off at Stevenson. So, we actually have a fullback this year that is actually an actual fullback, not a tight end. So, right now, we got to go sim the next game, the first preseason game against the Steelers, and see how well we do. So week one preseason, we win 27-9 over the Steelers. So we had a very good first week performance in the preseason. At least we're winning one game, at least. We actually won a game. We had a 5-game losing streak going into the end of the season last year. So at least we win our first game of the season, even if it is preseason, against those Steelers. So in that game, how did Kelly Bryant do? How did Kobe do? So passing-wise, K. Bryant had 74 yards passing, his first NFL touchdown in the preseason, and a 74.1 passing rating. Alex Smith had 68 and a touchdown, and Big Ben had 27 yards, so not that bad. Rushing-wise, we had 64 from Jeremy Hill there and 21 carries. We had 45 from Bell, 25 for Geis and a touchdown, and K. Bryant had 2 yards rushing, and that's about it. Receiving yards-wise, who led us in receiving? That was Eli Rogers at 36 and a touchdown, Paul Richardson at 30, 25 for Jordan Reed, 20 for Moncrief in his first NFL game as a Redskin, 13 for Jameson Crowder and a touchdown, and that's about it. Blocking-wise, who led up sacks? A bunch of people led up sacks, and only one of us was Eric Flowers. So only one of our offensive linemen led up sacks. That's a very good start. So when it comes to defense for the Redskins, newcomer corner Tony Lippett there, 7 tackles, 6 from Kareem Jackson, 5 from Pratt, 5 from Brown, and a tackle for a loss, 5 for Devin White in his first NFL game. Then, let's see sacks-wise. We had 2 sacks from Matthew Ioannidis, 1 sack from Sharif Miller in his first NFL game, 1 from Kerrigan, 1 for Arakpo back in the Redskins uniform, and 1 for Preston Smith. So hell of a game right there for us. Interceptions-wise, 1 for Zach Brown, 1 for Jonathan Abram in his first NFL game, and we had 1 for Fabian Moreau. Moreau is actually impressing. He's doing not that bad. I'll keep him on the roster if he keeps impressing like this. Plus, he had 2 tackles, too. Not that bad. So, very good games for everybody. Everyone's first NFL game here. We had 5 tackles from Devin White, so I like to see that. Kicking-wise, 2 for 2 for Dan Bailey, our newcomer kicker there, from straight out of Dallas. I like seeing made field goals this time. And Dustin Hopkins did not bring that last season. That's why we got rid of him. And 3 punts for 134 for the dude who can do no wrong, Tress Way. Kick return-wise, we had 47 for Eli Rogers, 24 for Dante Moncrief, and then 26 for Jameson Crowder on the punt return. So great week 1 for preseason. I don't think we have to cut anybody yet, but if we do, we'll just cut a bunch of those defensive tackles. But everyone had a great overall first game, though. Like, Devin White impressed. Michael Jordan didn't let up a sack. Warmack didn't let up a sack. Like, these dudes are doing very well for being rookies. And Abraham got a pick. Mullen didn't really do anything, I think. So there's nothing from Mullen yet. But, hey, still not that bad, though. We won that game 27-9. Let's move on to the next week, which is against the Detroit Lions. Week 2, we lose that one. 35-29, close game right there. Let's see what went wrong in that game against the Lions at home. So, K. Bryant, hell of a game for him. 231, 3 touchdowns, 139 passing rating, 78 yards was his longest pass. 0 times sacked in the entire game. Our offensive line is dynamite. I don't know how he lost that game. He has 61% completion percentage as well. So, K. Bryant, great game. Kobe's doing well. Matthew Stafford had 1 touchdown and 87 yards. But Matthew Moore there, 300 yards, 2 touchdowns, 119.8 passing rating, and Alex Smith at 118 and no picks. So our defense did not do well at all against Matt Moore, though. He had a great game. We had Myles Gaskin at 32 and a touchdown, or 2 touchdowns. Theo Riddick at 31, Hill at 25, Geis at 23, and so on. Receiving yards-wise, we had big games out of Jameson Crowder, 148 and a touchdown and 5 receptions. Galladay had 142 and 2 touchdowns. He had 74 from Luke Wilson, 61 from Austin Mack, the rookie, and a touchdown. Moncrief had 51 in his first Redskins touchdown. Then we had 34 for Jeremy Hill and a touchdown. Paul Richardson at 29. And looks like Nate Craig Myers got 16 yards on his first NFL catch. Then blocking-wise, as I said, didn't let up any sacks, but I guess Richie Incognito did, so must have let up a sack on Alex Smith. But Dimitri Lett let up a sack for the Lions. Defensively, 11 tackles there for Devin White, our 7th overall pick. He had no picks or sacks. Let's see down this list here for the Redskins. So Pratt had 7 tackles. Pratt's getting a lot of tackles, but that means he's probably either A, letting up receptions, or B, just very fast and getting to the running back. But DJ Swearinger there, 6 tackles there, 5 for Tony Lippett, 5 for Zach Brown, 4 for Jonathan Allen, 4 for Dunbar, and so on down the list. Abraham got his first NFL tackle there, 3 tackles. Mullen got 3 tackles. Arakpo got 3. And so on down the list. And Terrell Lewis got 2 tackles as well. QB sacks-wise, I don't think we got a sack. I guess we got 1. Half a sack from Allen and Payne. Then interceptions-wise, we had no interceptions in that game. Kicking-wise, 3 for 3 for Dan Bailey, 44 yards out is his longest. Punting-wise, 3 punts for Tressway again. Kick return-wise, we had 1 kick return each from Eli Rogers and Moncrief. And punt return-wise, 1 punt return for Jamison Crowder. So, I guess their defense did not do well enough against the Lions, and our offense didn't really keep up to the Lions' pace, so that's why we lost. But still, great game, though. I saw a lot of development out of Kobe Bryant, or K. Bryant, at quarterback. But we have the next game against the Titans there at home as well, so I guess we should go see that game first. But let's see if there's any new transactions or anything around the NFL. Because I know for sure we have to get rid of a lot of players either next week or this week, so let's go see some transactions. Looks like the Cowboys are 2-0, or 1-1, and the Eagles are 1-1, and the 0-2 Giants are in the NFC East preseason standings. But let's see transactions first. So transactions-wise, you have Spencer Novak being signed, Sheldon Day being signed, and a lot of players being signed. Nothing really huge to get from the free agency, because there's not that many big free agent picks left. But let's go to the next game, which is the Titans, and see if we win that game against the 2-0 Titans. Week 3, we win that one 27-24 against the Titans, and it looks like Geis has an upgrade. We'll do that upgrade first before we do anything. So Geis, elusive back, power back, or receiving back. You know what? Would improve his trucking. He needs more juking. He needs more elusiveness. We'll add that. So now Darius Geis cracked the 80 overall mark. And now he's finally in the 80s right now for that. Not bad. Not bad. Let's see defense. Anybody there for upgrades? No upgrades yet there for the starters. So let's go see that game against the Titans and see how we took that W. So K. Bryant there, 64 yards and a touchdown, a 127 passing rating. Great game from him. Alex Smith had 160 and a touchdown, 108.1 passing rating. Then DeAndre Francois, the player picked, a quarterback picked before K. Bryant by the Titans, 151, 2 touchdowns, 1 interception, and the loss hanging on his head. But he had a 105.3 passing rating, so great game out of Francois. But we have Marcus Mariota, 154, and a touchdown and a pick, and a 73.4 passing rating. But K. Bryant had a 62% completion percentage, not bad, and he was sacked 2 times on the day. Let's see rushing-wise. So, Jeremy Hill led the game there in rushing, 75 and a touchdown. Geis had 73 on 15 carries. Derrick Henry at 32, 27 from Deion Lewis, 10 from Mariota. Then receiving-wise, who led the game in receiving? Rashard Matthews did, 59. Jamison Crowder had 58 on 3 receptions. Tywan Taylor, 56. We have Paul Richardson, 41 and a touchdown. 34 from Jordan Reed, and 27 from Hill. And anything from Moncrief, 8 and a touchdown for Moncrief. Blocking-wise, let's see blocks. 2 sacks led up by Richie Incognito, 1 from Roulier, and Michael Jordan lets up his first NFL sack right there in that game, at least the first sack blamed on him. But defensively, we had, let's see the Redskins. So we had 9 tackles out of Zach Brown leading the game, 8 from Abraham there, we had 6 from Jonathan Allen and a sack, 5 from Quentin Dunbar, 5 from Mullen, 5 for Kerrigan and a half a sack, 5 for Devin White, 5 for Monte Nicholson, 5 for Arakpo and half a sack. Ioannidis had 4 and a sack, and Pratt had 3. And then Tim Settle had 2.5 a sack, and so on down that list. Who led us in sacks? It looks like it was Jonathan Allen had 1, Ioannidis had 1, and Sharif Miller had another sack there in that game, or at least in this preseason. Kerrigan had 0.5 sack, Arakpo 0.5 sack, Settle 0.5 sack, and Terrell Lewis 0.5 sack. Their first, I guess, somewhat NFL sack. He got 1/2 of one. But picks-wise, we had 1 pick from Zach Brown and 1 pick from Fabian Monroe again. He is doing well this preseason. Kicking-wise, we had 2 for 2 for Dan Bailey. He's basically indestructible. Dan Bailey is a beast. He hasn't missed a field goal yet this preseason. Tressway, 3 punts again for him. Kick return-wise, nothing really big there. Punt return-wise, nothing big there as well. So another good game out of the boys. But looks like Devin White led us in snaps there in that game. Last game is against the Rams in this preseason. We'll take a look at the NFC East standings. Cowboys are 3-0, we're 2-1, 1-2 Eagles, and 0-3 Giants. Any big transactions yet? Because we do have a lot to do this week because we have to cut a lot of players before we do anything. So we've got 17 players on the roster. We could probably put a lot of them on the practice squad. But Everett, we'll cut him. We don't need him. We got some rookies that are better than him, actually. So we'll get rid of him. Christian Powell, we'll get rid of him as well. Tim Settle, we'll leave Settle for now. Danny Johnson, I'm sorry, but we'll have to get rid of him. Then we have Trevor Knight, which we'll keep there as our third backup, our third quarterback. St. Brown will move into the practice squad because I like what he has. What else do we have on here? We have Sealer, their left end. Didn't really do that much. Didn't really impress me. So we'll get rid of him. Garen Christian, we do have a left tackle there already as our backup. But Christian will hold on to him, though. He's not bad. Holsey will get rid of Josh there. Porcher will get rid of Porcher there as well. Then Jeremy Sprinkle will hold on to him for now. Then what else? You have Troy Apke there, the free safety. He is 94 speed. We'll keep on hold on to him for that. Trey Quinn will move in the practice squad again. Rasheem Green, will leave him there as a backup right end. Keith Marshall, we'll just cut him right there. We don't really need him. Walruse, will keep him on the team so far. Duke Dawson Jr. will leave. Put him on the practice squad, actually. He'll get picked up easily, but we'll just leave him there for now. Nate Craig Myers, he had a good preseason. Not that bad, but we'll leave him to the practice squad because we don't really need him. Walruse, Fabian Monroe, we're not cutting. He had a great preseason for us. Walruse, we'll probably send him to the practice squad right there. We don't necessarily need him. Rasheem Green will leave for now. Jeremy Sprinkle, even though we do... I like him. I like his name, but we have better players. We'll just cut him. We don't really need him. Garen Christian will leave on the team. Trevor Knight will leave on the team. Tim Sell will leave on the team because he had a great preseason for us. So what do we do here with Christian? We'll leave him right there for now. Is there any more sacks that we could possibly do on this team? Maybe at cornerback. I don't know if I'll keep him on this team. He had a terrible preseason for us. And I don't really want what happened in the preseason happening to us in the season. So I might just get rid of him straight up right there. But right guards are good for now. Right tackle, Eric Flowers, are good for that right now. Left end, we're fine with that. Right end, we're good at that. D-tackle, got settled. We have a lot of D-tackles, actually. We'll just get rid of some of these D-tackles. We have David Jacobs. We have Orr. I'll get rid of Orr because we don't need him. Or can we just stick him on the practice squad? Why not? So you have two more players to cut. I'll get rid of Richie Incognito, probably. But left side linebacker. We want those guys. Middle linebacker, we're good at those guys. Right outside linebacker, we're good at those guys. Cornerbacks, we're good at those guys. So we have to cut one position. Receiver, we're fine with. Tight end, we're good at these three tight ends right there. Left tackle. Christian might have to be moved to the practice squad, I assume. We'll just move him right there. We don't necessarily need him right there. So we have one spot to go and open up right now. And that's going to take me right to our trade center. I'll go find a suitable trade for Richie Incognito, and then I'll show it. So I found a home in Arizona for Richie Incognito. Got a fourth round pick out of him. So that's pretty good, actually, for his value. So the roster cuts have been complete. And that means that Michael Jordan is now a starter on this team. So Mike, he had a great preseason. He deserves it. Now he's our starter at left guard. Then as for the rest of the team, we do have guys like Martin making the team. Bryant had a great overall preseason for us. He looks very good at backup quarterback this season. Then you have Strickland making the team there at tight end. And then who else made the team there? Ormack also made the team as a backup at left tackle. Then defensively, we have some defensive starters there, like Devin White is going to be our starter at middle linebacker, like I said before. Then we have Pratt making the team off of the undrafted free agent list. Then we also have Miller at a great overall preseason. Then you have Sharif Miller there making the team there. He had like two sacks in the preseason, so he had a great overall preseason for us. Then we have Abraham there. We had that pick in the first game for preseason. He made the team as our backup strong safety, obviously. Then Mullen, obviously, going to be our starter there at cornerback alongside Quentin Dunbar. Then special teams-wise, you have Dan Bailey, our kicker. He did not miss a single field goal in the entire preseason, so we got to go and... Actually, let's go take a look at some stats before we go and end off this preseason, just before we do anything. So, Kelly Bryant right now, first overall in passing touchdowns in the preseason. I'll just go to individual player stats right now. Bryant so far at 369, 5 touchdowns, 0 interceptions. Alex Smith at 346, 2 touchdowns. But Bryant did a 54% completion percentage so far. Then, rushing-wise, he had 164 out of Jeremy Hill in a touchdown, and 121 out of Geis in a touchdown as well. Receiving yards-wise, Jamison Crowder leading us in that, 219 and two touchdowns. Paul Richardson had 100 yards receiving, and that's pretty much about it. Then, as for blocking-wise, no sacks let up for the team, pretty much besides Chase, Eric, and one sack out of Michael Jordan being let up. Defensively, we have 21 tackles out of Devin White leading the team right now. Then quarterback sacks, leading us in sacks is Matthew Ioannidis. Then Sharif Miller has two sacks so far. Then picks-wise, we have two picks out of Zach Brown, two picks out of Fabian Monroe, and one pick out of Jonathan Abram. Kicking-wise, so far Dan Bailey 7-for-7, 46 yards out is his longest field goal. Punting-wise, there's the punts for Tress Way, and nothing big kick return or punt return-wise so far. So we'll go and sim the last game of the preseason, which is that Rams game. I just went through the stats quickly because you can't go through the stats after the preseason. So I might as well just go through the weeks 1-3 stats and then see what happens in that last game against the Rams. So let's go win this game. Final preseason game. Let's get it. So we lose the last game 24-10 in the preseason against the Rams. Let's just go see what happened there in that game. That's right, so you cannot see what happened in that Rams game. We lost 24-10. They really gotta change that so you can access previous preseason stats, but hey, it's just the way Madden is, so we cannot see those stats against the Rams. But we'll take a look at transactions and see who all got cut in the NFL, see if there's any big cuts or anything like that. So let's go down this list. So anything big yet? Doesn't look like there's anything big. There's Chuck Clark. Bengals signed Nate Craig Myers off for practice squad as predicted. What else happened? Garen Christian got signed by the Seahawks, so he's gone as well. Nothing big elsewhere. JC Jackson, Richie Watts, Simi Cobbs got signed by the Saints, their practice squad. Perry Crawford. A lot of no-name guys being signed and put on practice squads, but nothing big yet. Let's go see this cuts on here. See if there's any like NFL starters that were cuts or anything like that. Besides our cuts, doesn't look like there's anything big really in the NFL. A lot of nobodies that I have no idea who they are. Yeah, nothing big there for cuts right there. Let's see if there's any trades or anything. Only trade there was that Richie Incognito trade where we got a 4th round pick out of him. But it doesn't look like there's anything big from the preseason when it comes to cuts around the NFL. One last look at free agents. See if there's any top free agents available after those cuts. And there's like guys like JD McKissick, Jonathan Jones, Seals Jones, Cordy Grant, Carl Davis, Max Williams, Jordan Phillips, and a lot. Oh, there's John Ryan on there for punter. Nothing else. Yeah, nothing really big. There's Roberto Aguayo there, 73 overall, 25 years old, available for a kicker. Roger Lewis Jr. is actually available as well, too. Let's see Roger. Roger is... he's got some good stats, actually, for the most part. He's not that bad for a backup receiver. But I don't think we do have any roster space for him, really, because we're at basically the max for roster spots right now, and we had to make some harsh decisions. So I think we'll be fine for players right now. Anything good for practice squad eligibility? Devin Dunervey. We got Yadom, Montgomery, King... let's go see our practice squad quickly before we do anything else. So we have two players left, or at least two spots left there on a practice squad. Let's go add some two players quickly there. Anything good? Devin Dunervey. Let's go sort by speed. I just want to see who's the fastest guy available. Tony Brown at corner. Overall wise, you could probably get like a tackle on there, most likely. Like Sidney King wouldn't be bad to just add on there for a backup. So sign to the squad. Then we also have, who else? Marshall Scott. Yeah, we'll sign Marshall Scott there. Might as well do that. And he's quick development as well, too, actually. He wouldn't be bad to just add on the team. I think I also signed a quick development guy at strong safety as well for a backup. I'm pretty sure I did. Actually, looking at quarterbacks, we're carrying four quarterbacks. It's right, because we do have RG3 there as our third string quarterback. So might as well just get rid of Trevor Knight. We don't necessarily need him. And I don't think there's any space yet on the practice squad for him. We'll see. Because I want to leave him on the team if it's possible. Because I like him as a backup guy there for options. Okay, so when just added Duke Dawson to our main squad. I'll just go bring. Can we just go bring on Trevor Knight onto the practice squad? That'd be way easier. Because Duke Dawson does have quick development. That was the guy I signed that has quick development for the secondary. Let's go to quarterback, Trevor Knight. Hopefully we can add him. And we cannot add him. Okay, so he's not practice squad eligible, but we'll just get rid of him. There's a lot of quarterbacks around that are like him. So Trevor Knight, sayonara, buddy. You're gone. So even though he was a good quarterback, though, I like them. But we'll go to the practice squad, add one last player, because we have one spot open because we went and added Duke Dawson to the team. So we out goes Knight, in goes Dawson at corner. Let's go add like an offensive lineman on here. Like, I don't know. We could add like Rankin on here. I really don't care who we add. Add him onto there. And now our practice squad's full and our team is full and it's looking pretty good going into week one against the Dolphins. So the Dolphins, they have a very good team. At least they had a terrible team last season, but they added a lot of pieces. They look very good this year for the most part. We'll go set our season goal quickly before we do anything else. So this season, we finished with 5 wins last season, so I'm just going to go, let's go conservative. Let's go for 8 wins this season. Our team has improved in a lot of categories, and I think we could pull off at least 8 wins this season. So let's go commit that as our goal for the season, and then take a look at those Dolphins. So Dolphins, they added their top player now on the team, Stephon Diggs, the top free agent, 92 overall, 25 years old. He looks deadly in that offense. Plus, they have Ryan Tannehill, who didn't do well last year, but they also have backup quarterback Drew Lock, drafted like 13th overall in the draft last season. He's a 75 overall, 22 years old. Drew Lock looks very good for the future. Running back, they still have Drake. Fullback, they got Ritz. Then receiver, they have Stills, at Parker, Amendola, Jakeem Grant, who's a very fast, 96 speed. They have very, very speedy receivers, and it's looking pretty deadly, actually, for the most part. Tight end, they have Mike Gesicki. And they have Nicholas, left tackle, anything good. They have Remy Temzel still there on the team. And Steven Sanchez, they drafted in the draft this year. Left guard, we have Josh sitting there for the Dolphins. They have a good center there, and Spencer Long. Right guard, you have Jack Muhort. Right tackle, they have Juwan James. Left end, Claiborne. Right end, Harris. Defensive tackle, Spence. And they have linebackers are the only issue, actually. Damian Wilson there, 74, left outside linebacker. Actually, never mind, not linebackers. They have Shazier, 87 overall, signed in the free agency. They also have Navarro Bowman as a backup and McMillan there. Then right outside linebacker, they have D Ford. So the left and the right outside linebackers need some work. But cornerbacks, they have Fitzpatrick, McCain. Free safety, they have Jimmy Ward. Strong safety, they have Rashad Jones. Kicker, they have Myers. Punter, they have Hack. So their team matches up very well to our team for the most part, actually. We're better at quarterback overall. Running back, we're better for the most part. Receiver-wise, I'd say they're better. Tight end-wise, we're better. Left tackle-wise, we're better. Left guard, they're better. Center, we're better. I think we're actually tied, actually. Right guard, we're better. Right tackle, they're better. Then left end, we're about the same, I believe. Right end, we're better. Defensive tackle, we are better. Left outside linebacker, we're better. Middle linebacker, they're better. Right outside linebacker, middle linebacker. We have 88 Brown and 79, so I guess we're better at middle linebacker. Right, we're better. Cornerback, they're better. Free safety, they're better. Strong safety, they're better. And kicker, we're better. And punter, we're better. So I guess our team's a little bit better than theirs, but they could still pull off the last second W if they hold our offense on the day to like a couple points, because their defense is very good for the most part. So anyway, next episode will be the week one game against the Miami Dolphins. So make sure to like and subscribe for that, and thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.